Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where we are going to interact and also learn together. We are going to have our mathematics form 1, our lesson 4, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald, and we are going to handle the topic on factors. Let us begin so that we understand each and every concept. But before that, we are going to have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to express numbers in terms of their prime factors, and also you should be able to know the divisibility test of numbers, that is from that is the counting numbers. Let us start with the first one, which is the factors. Now when we refer to factors, here you are going to consider the statement 3 times 4, whereby you are getting 12. So here the numbers 3 and 4 are being termed as the factors of 12. The table below shows some factors. Let us now, for example, we have already looked at the factors of 12, but now here we are going to look it deeply. So the factors of 12, we can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. That is, in short, the factors are the numbers that are multiples of the number that are being given. For the case of 16, we can have 1, 2, 4, 8, and also 16. And for the case of 7, are the factors of 7 and 1 and 7. Now we have something else known as prime factors. You can also be required to you get the prime factors of a given problem. For example, when you're required to get the prime factors of something like 300, what you normally do, you draw a table, then you divide by 300, you divide by 2 to get 150, 150 divided by 2 to get 75. 75 is not divisible by 2, so we get to the other factor, that is 3 to get 25. 25 you divide by 5 to get 5, and 5 you get by 5 to get 1. So our aim here, what you should do, you divide the number until the end you get 1. That is to satisfy that you've gotten all the prime factors of a given number. In the case of 512, so you divide by 2, you get 256, and it continues that way. In terms of its prime factors, for example, the number 300, as you can see, we have gotten it is 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 5. So when you are required to get the prime factors of 300, as you can see from our screen, the factors of 300 are 2 times 2 times 2, times 3 times 5 times 5. So the factors, you can get 2, because 2 is appearing 2 times, we can write it as 2 squared. 3 is appearing only 1, so we can have it as 3 power 1, or we can ignore the 1 and you multiply by 5 squared. For the squared, it is to mean 5 is appearing 2 times. We can have a divisibility test whereby you can say a number is divisible by 2 if the last digit is 0 or even an even number. Remember, we are saying that a number is divisible by 2 if the last digit is 0 or an even number. For example, you can have the number 20. If you are being asked, is number divisible by 2? The answer is yes, because the last digit is 0. For example, if you are, what about 8? Is 8 divisible by 2? The answer is yes, because it is an even number, same as 16. So, at a quick test, we can have which of these numbers are divisible by 2, that is 6, 30, 486, 405, and 362. Very fast, we can see 6, that is divisible by 2, because its last digit is 0. Same as 486, because it's an even number. But 405 is not divisible by 2, since its last digit is neither 0 nor is it an even number. We can go to the divisibility test of 3. Whereby we say a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digit is divisible by 3. We can have the following numbers. Let us look at 99. When we say the sum of digits, here you are going to get 9 plus 9. 9 plus 9, we are getting 18. Is 18 divisible by 3? Yes. So 18 divided by 3, you are going to get it as 6. So that is to mean 99 is divisible by 3. Let us have a number like 1257. So we are going to get the addition of the digits. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8, and 8 plus 7 is 15. So is 15 divided by divisible by 3? Yes, because it's only 5 times. So that is to mean 1257 is divisible by 3. Let us have another number like 15. Let us get the sum of the digits whereby it is 1 plus 5 to get 6. Is 6 divisible by 3? The answer is yes, because 6 is divisible by 3 to get 2. So that is the divisibility test of 3. And we have said a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. We can go to the divisibility test of 4. And whereby we're going to say a number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits are both 0 or form a number which is divisible by 4. For example, we can have a number like 48. Let us 48 is the last two digits is they are not both zeros, but we can go to our next statement whereby we are saying they form a number which is divisible by 4. 48 is divisible by 4 because we are going to get 12. Let us go to divisibility test for 5, whereby we are going to see a number is divisible by 5 if the last digit is 0 or 5. You can have any number. For example, you can have a number like 3000. 3000 is divisible by 5 because the last digit is 0. Or you can have a number like 10250001025. As long as the last digit is 0 or 5, you don't need to look at the other numbers, but you only consider the last digit. So if the last digit is 5 or 0, that number you automatically say it is divisible by 5. Having done and said that, you can have the following activity whereby you are required to express 420 in terms of its prime factors, and also you test whether 543 is divisible by 3. For more reference, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Mathematics Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. Or, and to get this lesson and many more, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Let us subscribe to all this channel and we shall get more of our mathematics from one lessons. Thank you.